That's okay.
Yeah, okay. Line up.
Hi.
You're Stan Lindsay.
Just wave to the camera. Wave to the camera. Hey. Kona, don't forget Kona.
How's the gang from Kona?
Don't fall. Man, how old are you? What's my name?
Why not?
Yeah.
Is that breakfast?
It's Gatorade.
Gatorade. Steroids? We just get here?
I just arrived.
Well, I'm glad you're dressed. I've been planning games.
Well,
Jim's Nare wanted a tank top, so we made him a tank top. He said, the next time we're going to get tank top.
And who's this? Jamie.
Brian.
Pitcher. With.
Yeah.
Aww.
I guess she knows who you are now.
She was just smiling. She
always. Yeah.
Tom, is that breakfast?
Of champions.
Okay.
Clash of the Anheuser-Busch.
Oh, it's in
here?
Oh, boy.
Oh,
good to come
Good morning,
good
Mr.
morning,
photographer. And how are you this morning?
Okay.
Good to see you again. Camera.
Thank you.
take care of it.
Yeah, I think, yeah, right. Yeah. Slides of tequila should be fine.
Pick me up! No? Oh, mommy's playing and she's crying.
Hey, Tim, watch out for the cucumbers here.
Baby, you don't want to sleep this time?
You're not going to do it?
No, I can't. He's not going to relent to anybody.
All right.
what are we doing?
John, this is for the camera now.
Get it, right?
good. We got it. We got it. We got it. Big shot all the way back. Straight ahead. Straight ahead. Straight ahead. Who's next? Who's next? Let's go. We're first. We won. We done. We done.
They kept telling us, they kept putting back our delivery date, you know, later and later. So even though we had our money in escrow,
hi, JR.
You know, we wrote a letter and everything explained that we had another opportunity to buy it. So they let us
anyway, what
get
you
out.
Want to do is.
Well, Pat, how's it going for you?
Okay, right in the middle. Oh,
good,
his head.
See, I made a bird.
But
that does look like
right
a bird.
On the top of his head.
Hold it up for the camera.
The fat end.
There you go.
And then this skinny end.
To say?
Yes, this is a very vigorous volleyball game going on here with Julie Nare serving right now.
Yes, Tom is our narrator and the referee service 13
off. Nice try. Nice try. What? What? All right, guys. All right, settle down.
This is it. We like it under pressure.
Yeah.
Did you all win? Did you win?
We lost.
You lost.
We want to reinforce, as well as we know how, the meaning of family in our company, and that we do appreciate not only the dedication of the members of the Hemmeter Aviation staff itself, but the kind of understanding and compassion that the members of their families and friends have to contribute in order to understand why Bobby Pesquera, for example, is getting up at 3 in the morning to come and meet an airplane, or why Mark Livingston has to get up in the middle of the night to meet an airplane, and the fellow who gets off the airplane is inebriated and he doesn't even know that anybody's there. So it's important, I think, that we take this moment to say thank you to all of you and to all of your families for understanding the very unusual nature of our company and the kind of special dedication that you have to have in order to continue to push it forward. From my personal point of view, there's no question that you folks continue to make me look like an unusually talented businessman. We all know what the truth is, right? We all know that that's not true, and that it's the people who are in the front lines and who know the customers and what the customers really need and what constitutes value in the eyes of the customers that makes this company work. It's a very unusual company in many different ways. Those of you who've been around for the 3.5-4 years that we have know that we are growing at a very, very rapid rate. This 1989 will be the first year that Hemmeter Aviation has not doubled its size, which is a 100% annual growth rate. Obviously, you cannot keep doubling your size and expect to stay a healthy company. And this is the first year we're beginning to taper off. We will have a significant growth rate this year, but not a doubling of size again. You know that we have a successful operation in Gander, Newfoundland. The last few months, the company began to turn a profit. And although it's a small operation, about 11 or 12 employees, it's getting to be as famous for the transatlantic people who travel across the Atlantic Ocean as we are in the Pacific. And of course, we're very grateful to the people over there who have made it so very professional in our name. It's easy to be a successful leader when you have really sharp people on your team. And from my point of view, I want to thank you once again for making me look really good. And I want to just thank you again for pushing forward in the direction we have. There are going to be some changes in the future. You've already begun to suspect them. I think we're going to have a very exciting fall season. Business is up all year. This month started off a little slow, but I think it's going to pick up toward the end of the month. And there's going to probably be some changes in terms of the kinds and the numbers of aircraft that we have visiting us on a regular basis. We're going to go into a few new businesses, and I'll talk a little bit about that at another time. But tonight is your night. And for you and your families and your friends who are here, I give you a heartfelt aloha and mahalo, and thank you very much for the wonderful dedication you've shown all year. Right now, I'm going to turn over the microphone to Tom Anusiewicz, who is one of the people that I deeply respect in helping to forge this company in the last few years into what it has become. Tom, why don't you come up here and take over the program? Thank you.
Wow, what a day, huh? A lot of good people. A lot of good fun. I don't know where those cucumbers came from today, but it's been a good day. I don't know where they think up all these games they put us through. But it really has been a lot of fun. It's kind of good for me because I got to go to Maui last week. And I got to do it there, and I got to do it here. And Wednesday I'm going off to Gander, and I'm going to get to do it again. It really feels good to be part of the appreciation for everybody, because I really feel very close to everybody in Maui, here, throughout the islands, and in Gander itself. I don't know what what they're going to cook up in Gander. I don't know if they can top Ann and the guest service people with the games they put together, but codfish toss. I don't understand that one. Something about moose antler or ring toss. There's some good ones coming up, but so it ought to be real exciting. I really have to just say thank you to everybody for all the things that we've done and accomplished this year. It's, we've gone through a lot. We've learned a lot. We've taken the time to go through a program this year that has been kind of exciting for me. To start a new alertness with everybody, to become a little bit closer with themselves and closer as a team, because the team is going to make the difference. And this is a team. This is a family. And I have to also thank all the families that are here, because I agree with Bob. Without them, with all the work that we do, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, wouldn't be possible without the families. So at this point, I'd like to get into the program. We have a number of things to do. We've had the Hoss elections. That ought to be interesting. They were last year. We'll get into some prizes. We're going to have Julie and Bobby come up to do that. And then we've got some entertainment for some of the people. We have a lot of talented people with us. So I'm going to ask Malia and Ann to come up. And before I leave, I want to thank all the people that helped put this on together, put this thing together today. Especially Ann, I think that she has done an awful lot of work as she did last year, and I think she deserves a hand for helping us put it together. Ann, you want to take over at this point? Malia? She's out of her comfort zone.
Doesn't need a microphone.
What we want to do first of all is give out some of the team prizes for our competition today. Team prizes. I'm sure you all know that you weren't doing it for just for fun, that you were also evaluated for your performance today. Okay, so starting off with third place, which is actually last place. This team had a really slow start, but they started to pick up points later in the afternoon, about the second to the last game. But they held out, you know, they were really, they participated. No, they claimed that they didn't have enough male on their team, so. Third place goes to the Gulf Stream. Which is captain by John Mason and co-captain Joni Torres. John, Joni. Oh, I'm sorry, it was John and Layla. I had too much noise.
Go ahead, Layla.
So, the recognition of your efforts, our third place prize is a box of suckers. For first place, so second place is also known for the most spirited team, and it's the team that grumbled the most too about the points, and that goes to the challengers, Julie Ray and Tim.
Jim.
both race and they both performed really well, and it ended up with a tie for Boeing and the Falcon. The Boeing is captained by Tom Anusowitz and co-captain Jamie. And the Falcon from Captain Sam Kamakau, co-captain with Joni. Sam?
As I said, the Boeings were for sale, but our price just went up.
Okay, and you know that we never, never have a tie. Okay, so there's a tiebreaker right now. Okay? So, we're gonna do it in a very diplomatic way. Duncan Paul. Selection winners, the most important thing, because we all know that you're all nominated. It's been nominated by your peers, so here we go. And that's Tom Anusowitz. Oh, we'd like Tom to share his gift with us.
Fifteen excellent paper airplanes.
Okay, in the next category, Speedy Gonzalez. Fastest feet, most productive, moves quickly, reacts spontaneously, and most efficient. And that goes to John Mason. This is the second year in a row that John has won the Speedy Gonzalez Award.
White socks, go with the white uniform.
A Winnie the Pooh is a new category. A Winnie the Pooh is the most personable, friendly, warm, outgoing individual. And the winner on Winnie the Pooh is Debbie Weiss. Deborah.
our next category is Bam Bam, and he's the most athletic, the one who's physically fit, energetic, flexible, and strong. And I'm sure he demonstrated that today in the wheelbarrow race. Our Bam Bam is Marky L. You know, those of us in the company that are getting on in years know, you know when you're getting older when you say to someone, do you remember Foghorn Leghorn, and they look at you completely blank. But Foghorn Leghorn is a giant chicken.
Rooster.
Thank you. So he's a giant man chicken, and he's also very ambitious, he's determined, he's clever and witty, and we voted him most likely to succeed, and our optimist, and that is John Mason.
I'm only playing you one time.
Flight operations has been really well represented in the award so far. Our next category is the Pepe Le Pew Award. And Pepe Le Pew is the most humanistic, our sensitive, warm-hearted, but very amorous, kinesthetic person in the company. And our Pepe Le Pew Award goes to Amanda Forsyth. Okay. Pepe Le Pew is working at 5:30 tomorrow morning. The next category is Mr. Clean, and that's our best dresser, always neat and sparkling clean, orderly, and our Mr. Clean is a Mrs. Clean, Julie Naray. Award, and I hate to say it, but most of the votes or the nominees were from our guest services department. Boy, and close behind was Gina, and also Donna Ferreira, and also the newcomer Roxanne was not too far behind. Besides Toxan, but the last couple of votes was a runaway, and the winner for Donald Duck, which is the most assertive, is Malia Pang. Yay! Everybody can Okay, our next award is the Schroeder Award. And Schroeder is our most talented, skilled professional, intelligent. It says you're shy and auditory. And those are all big hints, but our Schroeder Award this year goes to Anne Vasconcellos. Yeah. Our final category is the Tasmanian Devil. And the Tasmanian Devil is the most mischievous, creates a stir, playful, determined, ravenous appetite, and very visual. Our Tasmanian Devil this year is Bobby Pescara.
I really didn't expect this. I say there. And what it, Tasmanian Devil. Let's open it up and see what it. Great. I need all this energy for my devilish. It's a bag of super poo-poo, you guys. Thank you.
That's all of the categories for the Haas elections. We'll be passing out the program so you can enjoy the photos. Thanks.
Two nights. Round trip airfare for a couple, limousine service to and from the airport at Bob Fishman's house. I couldn't refuse that. Weston and Kauai, limousine to and from your house, airfare. And I'll have, Kehal, are you busy? Would you like to pull the name for the grand prize overall? I'll have my daughter Kehal pull the name, this way you won't say it's fixed. Just close your eyes, Kehal, and just reach in and pull a name. Are you ready? Go ahead, Kehal. And the winner is? Jim from Kona. Jim from Kona, Western Kauai. Mr. and Mrs. or Jim and girlfriend. Two nights, airfare. Limousine service. Come on down, Jim, don't be shy. You're one of the family. All right, grand prize winner. Jim, you can give it away, you know. Congratulations, Jim.
Thank you very much.
Would you like to say a few words of whatever?
Sure.
All right, go right ahead.
Thank you, Hemmeter Aviation. This is a real nice company to work for. I just started. And this is even better. Thank you.
Okay, we have another prize. We have two more prizes. Again, we're gonna have two, three. Okay, we have three more prizes, ladies and gentlemen. Please bear with me. We're so prosperous this year, we're gonna give everything away. Bob's BMW, the works, you know. Okay, now this time, I'm not gonna have KL pull the prize, the name. Mr. Hanalei Pasquara, would you like to pull a name, please?
Shut up, Bobby, you're bound to pull your name.
Okay, and for one of the three surprise packages, the winner is Roxanne Coon. This is the lady with the baby. $1 a ticket for 100 votes. Her baby name is Noelle. From
Noah.
Hammer Key, right? All right, again, the second of the three surprise packages. Julie would like to pull a name. And the winner is, this doesn't count. That was her name. Okay, no. And the winner is Jamie. Come on down. Surprise package. There you go, Jamie. You're welcome. All right, last and final door prize. And the winner is Calvin Condominium. Come on down, Calvin. Now, this is the last of the Dole Prizes Award. Again, I repeat myself. In a few minutes, we're going to have you. Thank you, Cal. Our next agenda on the program would be a talent show by the people of Hemmeter Aviation. Duane is...
Love him all.
Okay, we're gonna do this.
Okay, we're gonna do this number called Hi'iwai, and it tells a story about this freshwater clams that comes down from the island of Molokai in the river area, and it's called Hi'iwai. Hina pali ve hi ve hi, oke ko olau. Ai kanangi o Molokai na, ina pali ve hi ve hi, oke ko olau. He amai kane o hande, ike a. I can make me a kebune, omolobui. Ehi, vai la la lai, ero I mai ka huana. I ka aina ulubehi, o aila u. Hano hano vale no u, no ai lele ka ibala. Ame ke kuaibi, o molokui. Mele ka kolei a pau, I ka mele ai nana. O kandan ni mai ole, o ke o ua. I ka makan ni uluveru, o ke kai pupu o vai. I ka aina uluvehi, no kuikino. Ehi I vai lalailai, he ho I mai ka uana. I ka aina uluvehi, o aila uhe. Hano hano wale no u, to wai lele ka iwana. Ame ke kuaibi, o molokui. Ehi I vai lalailai, he ho I mai ka uama. I ka aina uluvehi, o aila. Hano hano wale no u, to wai lele ka iwana. Ame ke kuaibi, o molokui. Ame ke kuaibi, o molokui.
We're going to have Lisa come up. And at the meantime, I'm going to have my two daughters sing this song for Lisa. And it's Ka'ula Vehi O Kikai.
Notice, yeah, Dwayne's family got all the talent over here.
Yeah, Dwayne, all right.
Yeah. It's all hidden at home.
Hidden.
Well, we're going to have Lisa do Ka'ula Vehi O Kikai. And it tells a story about this seaweed, how it caresses in the ocean side, and as they pick it up and they put it in the basket. Okay, Lisa, are you ready?
Thank you.
Tom does a number.
Okay, yeah. And he had his guitar. Hi, opua, ikawai, aohe lua e mikiai, me o. You're going to get lickings. Don't make me laugh. Malihini mako ia owe ikonda ike kono ake uke aloha no mako. Malihini mako ia owe ikonda ike kono ake uke aloha no mako. Aina ia mai kana kapuana aohe lua e nikiai me oe. Aina ia mai kana kapuana aohe lua e nikiai me oe. This is all for you guys, Sam and Kona.
Harry, all right, Harry.
Okay, Harry, Harry, it's your turn.
Yeah, Harry, it's okay.
Give me 5 minutes.
Give me 2 minutes.
Wait, one more.
Can you tell the players about our scorecard, right? So we got patch job. Anyway, I know this is out of tune. I'm sorry, folks, but we're gonna try one anyhow. Country music, if you will, has. It's popular songs. You can't hear this? Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. Oh, look out. Pick it up. If I had to say one guy was the most instrumental in bringing country music out of the closet in the basement, taking the hayseed out of it, and taking that uptown, so to speak, and getting it respectable, along with all other kinds of music, if you will. Well, the guy named Johnny Cash, he had a national syndicated TV show, and he really brought it ahead with it. Okay? I'd like to do one of his numbers that he sold perhaps a few million on. I cut it one time in an LP I had, and I sold 12 of those. My family bought them all, and I bought 6 of those, okay? And I had trouble giving those away, but it's a song about tomorrow morning. For those of you who know what Saturday nights can do and how you feel the next morning about it. One called Sunday Morning, Coming Down. Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head. That didn't hurt. And the beer I had for breakfast was in bed. So I had one more for dessert. And I fumbled through the closet, through my clothes, and found my cleanest dirty shirt. And I washed my face and combed my hair, stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I'd lit my mind the night before with cigarettes and songs that I've been a-picking. And I lit my first and watched the small kid playing with a can that he was kicking. And I walked across the street, caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. And Lord, it took me back to something I'd lost somehow, somewhere along the way. And on a Sunday morning sidewalk, wishing, Lord, I was stoned, for there's something in a Sunday makes the body feel alone. Now there's no fear of dying, and half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk. And Sunday morning coming down. But I figured you had enough of that one, right?
This is
our only second year with the Employees Appreciation Day. Some faces that were at last year's are not here this time, and some new ones are here that weren't here last year. Let's do an old Buck Owens number called Together Again. Together again. My tears have stopped falling. The long, lonely nights are now at an end. The key to my heart you hold in your hand, and nothing else matters now. We're together again. Together again. The gray skies are gone. You're back in my arms, back where you belong. The world that we knew is living again, and nothing else matters now. We're together again. Oh, nothing else matters, honey. We're together again. Oh, yeah.
All right, Harry. Woo, Harry.
Oh, I can't stop loving you. I made up my mind to live in memories of the lonesome time. And I can't stop wanting you, it's useless to say. So I'll just live my life, dream of yesterday. Those happy hours, oh, we once knew so long ago, still make me blue. They say that time heals a broken heart, but time has stood still since we're apart. I can't stop loving you. I've made up my mind to live in memories of a lonesome time. I can't stop wanting you, it's useless to say. So I'll just live my life and dream of yesterday.
Woo!
I don't want to overstay my welcome, so. And it's getting late. Here's a tearjerker by a man who can sing most any kind of music. His voice has been stilled now, but he's played everywhere that I can think of, and I used to follow behind him. A guy called Monty Robbins. A lot of songs that he wrote had to do with his wife, like My Woman, My Wife, if you remember those songs. But here was one called You Must Be a Walking Piece of Heaven. What's that round your head? Is it a halo? And what's that on your shoulders? Is it a wing? Oh, you must be a walking piece of heaven. Or is it love that makes me see these things? Around you, there's a light that keeps on glowing. And when you speak, do I hear angels sing? Oh, you must be a walking piece of heaven. Or is it love that makes me see these things? And when we met, you gave me strength to face the world. Oh, and I believed you're special. You're an ordinary girl. Now am I seeing right? Or am I dreaming? And do I hear the rustle of the wind? Oh, and you must be a walking piece of heaven. Or is it love that makes me see these things? Sound effects in country music when we don't have the gimmicks to do it with. Most of you know popular music has some standards and certainly some classics. Like pop music has New York, New York, and Chicago is a wonderful town, and the old city by the bay means San Francisco. Well, country music had theirs too. They had San Antonio, Atlanta, GA, and here's one that called Detroit City. Last night I went to sleep in Detroit City, and I dreamed about those cotton fields and home. Oh, I dreamed about my mother, dear old sister, dad, and brother. I dreamed about the girl who's been waiting for so long. I want to go home. We're all going home. Oh, Lord, how I want to go home. Now, home folks think I'm big in Detroit City. From the letters that I write, they think I'm fine. By day I make the cars, by night I make the bars. If only they could read between the lines. Well, you know, I went and caught me a train on up to that dadgum Detroit city. Yeah, and after all this time, I found that I'd just been wasting my time. So I think I'm gonna tuck in my foolish pride and I'm gonna put it on a southbound freight and ride. And I'm gonna head on back down home to the loved ones I left waiting behind. I wanna go home. Oh, I wanna go home. Oh, Lord, I wanna go home. Say my welcome, but should I do another? What am I gonna do? Oh, please release me, let me go. 'Cause I don't love you anymore, and to live. Our life would be a sin. Oh, release me and let me love again. For I have found a new love, dear. And if only I could have her near. Why her lips are warm while yours are cold. Release me, my darling, let me go. Yes, release me, my darling, let me go. Good night, everybody. Appreciate it very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. That pretty much concludes the program for tonight. For those that are not staying and driving back into, further down the line, please drive carefully, and we'll all see you back at work. Thank you very much. Good night.